Hello students, welcome to my channel. This is Subodh Kumar. So today we are going to discuss about the string handling in C language. So what is a string? A string is an array of characters. In this session, in part 1, we learn how to declare string, how to work with a string in C programming, and in part 2 of this session, we will learn how to use the predefined string handling functions. In the part 2 of this session, we will see how to compare two strings, concatenate or merge strings, copy one string to another string, and perform various string manipulation operations. We can perform such operations using the predefined functions of string.h header file. As you know, in your syllabus, string is a very important topic. Here you can see in the syllabus we have a string variables, reading and writing strings, arithmetic operators on characters, comparison of two strings, string handling functions, tables and other features of C. So this is very important topic in your syllabus. So first of all, let us discuss how to declare a string. A string can be declared basically in two ways. In first method, we write the data type as char, as a string is defined as a character of array of characters. So the data type we used here is char, then the name of the character array, that is name of the string, then the brackets equals, and in parentheses or in braces, we have to write individual characters enclosed in single quotes separated by comma, and we have to also provide a null value denoted by /0. So this is the first way in which we initialize the string by individual alphabets or characters. In second method, we can assign the string value by putting double quotes to the string. The /0 would automatically inserted at the end of this type of declaration. So in method 1, for example, here I have written data type char, name of the string is country, then bracket, and then individual character INDIA, and then /0. If we assign the characters individually, then we have to assign null character at the end of the string. In the second method, the complete word India can be assigned by writing it in double quotation marks. Here, size of the array is optional. We can also declare a string as char, name of the array country, then the size, here I have given 20, equal, and then the string value. But if you want to just declare a string without the initial value, then size must be given as char, array name, and size. But if you try to declare a string, that is character array, without a given size, then it will give an error. So we have to give the size if we are not going to initialize a string. If you are going to initialize a string, then size is optional. Your size is given, your size is not given. So in the above declaration, null character will automatically be inserted at the end of the string. What is the null character? /0. /0 represents the end of the string. It also referred as string terminator and null character. One thing also we have to remember, that any character, whether it is a numeric array, any array, whether it is a numeric array or a character array, the name of the array points to the first location of the array. Here in this examples, The array name country points to the first character, that is country of index 0, where I is stored. So the name of the array acts like a pointer. Here we can say it as internal pointer. When we explicitly declare a pointer using asterisk operator, then those are external pointer. And here array, which acts like a pointer, is called internal pointer. Now let us discuss about how to input and output a string in C program. So basically we have two methods for input and output of strings. By using printf and scanf function, printf is used for displaying a string and scanf is used for reading a string. Similarly, puts and gets. Puts is used to display a string and gets is used to input a string. Now let us see the syntax of above functions. In printf function, we have to provide the control string for a string. It is present s and the name of the string. But in case of puts, we have to provide only name of the string or character array. Here percentage as format string is not required. Now the next function is scanf function. It is used to input a string. It has two arguments. The first argument is percentage s, the format s specifier for a string, and the second argument is the string name or character array. Here ampersand is not written, because the second argument means or represents the address of the variable in which we want to input a data. Here the array name str1 itself points to a memory location of the first element of the array. So here str1 is already pointing to a memory address. So ampersand or address operator required. The next function gets is used to input a string, but it has only one argument, that is name of the string. Here percentage s is not required. But the basic difference between the scanf function and gets function is that in the case of a scanf function, we cannot accept a string having white spaces. For example, space, tabs, etc. So we can only input a single word if we use a scanf function. But in case of gets function, it can read a string which can include white spaces such as space and tabs. So in most of the cases, we use gets function. These functions, that is printf, scanf, gets and puts, is declared in stdio.h header file, that is standard input output header file. Now let us see a program to read a string and display a string using printf and scanf function. So here is the program. In this program, we have declared a character array of size 20, in which we have accepted a name using scanf function, and we have displayed that name using printf function. Let us execute this program in code block IDE. And we will see how it will be executed and give us output. Now start a new file, give it a name.
string 1.c. Save it, click on OK. Here is the program. Remove these comments, it is not required here. Now our program is ready. Save the file. So in line number 8, the scanf function is used to accept a string, and in line number 9, printf function is used to display a name, a string. Now click here, rebuild the file and click on build and run. Here is the output. Now enter a name. Current. Now we will get the output. Current. Now if we win input, again I am going to execute this program. If you input a name having space, such as Karan Kumar, let us see what will be the output. Here the output is Karan. The string Kumar is not accepted in the variable name because here space is present in the string. So the first word Karan is accepted into the string name. So to accept the complete string, we have to use getS function. Now let us write another program which uses a getS function and putS function to input and display a string. I am going to copy this program into our editor. Remove all those comments, it is not required here. Now here we are using getS function in line number 12 to input a string and putS function to input to display a string. Now rebuild the program. Click on build and run. Now I am entering Karan Kumar. Here the output is Karan Kumar. That is, the getS function accepted all the characters including space into the string name. So getS function is more useful than a scanf function to read a string. One thing should be noted, that if we use getS function to input a string, then it is not required to use putS function to display a string. Suppose we are using printf function to display a string, then there is no problem. Then there will be no problem. Execute the program. Karan Kumar, and the output is Karan Kumar. So we can use printf function as well as putS function to display a string. Now in part 2 of this session, I will discuss about some of the string functions such as strlen, strlwr, strupr, strcat, strcpy. and so on. Thank you.